Trump is the result of decades of us allowing this country to go down a road that had very little to do with democracy and equal rights and what was fair, and very much toward letting the rich, letting corporate America, Wall Street, run the show and call the shots. So when I say that, for instance, that Donald Trump doesn't care much about democracy and is trying to whittle away whatever he can of what we call our democracy, that's really, to be fair to him, not really unusual. He's a CEO. He's a billionaire. Generally, CEOs don't run their businesses like democracies. They don't like democracy. That's not how they live. It's not how they run their business. And as billionaires, they want to grab as much of the pie for themselves as possible. So they're not into everybody having a slice of the pie or a fair slice of the pie or a seat at the table. So he's really just acting like most people of his class. You know, I mean, I got to believe if you're a billionaire, you've got to really hate a system that says it's one person, one vote. Because if we really are one person, one vote, that means there's 325 million of us and probably less than 1,000 of them. That, imagine if you were on the other side, if you were one of them, that doesn't look very good. Because it means that 325 million can just suddenly pass laws and tell you what to do. So the basic concept of our democracy is that. But they know that they've been able to run that show because they've bought it. They buy the politicians, they buy the elections, and they have most working people in such a box that they know that if they were to protest, if they were to speak out, if they were to whistleblow, that would be the end of their income.